Hi there, my name is X01 and I'm from Horizon Development Team. In this short video, I'm going to show you how you can prepare your PC for developing mods for Inner Core for Horizon. So you will find the links in the description of the video. The first link is to Inner Core Toolchain, and this is a repository where you can find everything to develop your mods for Horizon using Java, JavaScript, C++, and even some more languages if you would like to do so. And also there are some links here to the requirements, and I will leave them also under the video. These are the things you should install before we start. And in this video, I'm going to show you the process of the installation, etc. So the first thing you'll need is Python of any version upper than 3.6. So current version is 3.8.2. On my own PC, I'm running 3.7. So you should install Python. So what you need to do to check your installation is press Win plus R, type CMD, it's the command line, and type Enter, press Enter, and then type Python dash dash version. And this will show your current installation, your current version of Python. It should be more than 3.6. Okay, so when you are done installing Python, you should go to the SDK platform tools. So to verify if you have such an installation, open the file explorer, go to the local drive C, users, your username, app data, local. If you do not see the folder called app data, you can just press here on the path and type percent app data percent, and this will switch you to the roaming folder. You'll go one folder upper and then go to local. So here you should see the folder called Android, and if you were using Android Studio or however else developing for Android, you will see that you have an SDK folder. Otherwise, you should install it manually, and the thing you will need is the platform tools of your SDK. So if you do not have the SDK folder, so if you don't have Android SDK on your PC, just download the platform tools from the Android developer website, the link in the description, and then I'll show you where to write it, where to specify the path to the Android platform tools in this video, just after we install everything else. So the next thing is Android NDK installation. It is required only for native modding, so if you're going to write your code in C++, if you're going to explore the Minecraft native library and to create some mods using some really cool methods that are available there, you should install also a valid Android NDK. So we recommend using R16b, so it's the version, it's the name of the release. To download it, you should go to the older versions, unsupported NDK downloads, and agree to the terms, and you will see a lot of installation variants. So you should go to revision 16B, dated December 2017. And download the binaries for your platform. So after downloading an archive, it's quite large, so around 600 megabytes, you should unpack it into the folder called app data local Android, Android NDK R16B. So that's the folder where Horizon Toolchain will look for your local Android NDK installation. And just verify that you just have a folder called Android NDK R16B, and in this folder you have just a lot of files, some CMD files, some readme files, etc. So that you don't have another nested folder inside. Okay, when done, you should also go back to the CorTool chain guide and also verify that you have Java Development Kit 1.8 or higher. We currently didn't test it with Java 11, so we are not able to guarantee it works well. So I would recommend to install the 1.8 Java Development Kit, and the link to it will also be in the description. And also, the Oracle now require that you create an account before downloading Java Development Kit. So you create an Oracle account and you log in with it, and then you are able to download the binaries for your platform. So you install the program, and then you should restart your computer so that all the changes are applied. And finally, there is an integrated development environment. It is not generally an integrated development environment. It's more like a code editor, but it is extendable to an IDE and integrated development environment via plugins. So we will extend Visual Studio code editor with some plugins and also with some configuration files that are available in the toolchain to create a complete integrated development environment. So you just install your stable build for Windows, or doesn't matter what platform you have. And then switch to open it and switch to extensions tab. Here we will install some extensions that are really useful for development. So for JavaScript and probably TypeScript developer, you should install TS-Lint by Microsoft. So be sure to install the TS-Lint by Microsoft and not the deprecated by Gamma. Yeah. And also to write C++ code, you should install the extension called C++. Also, it's an extension by Microsoft. Here it is. Here's its icon. So you install that. And also for Java, it is not a single extension, it's Java Extension Pack. Here it is. Java Extension Pack includes six extensions that allow you to develop for Java really very convenient in a very convenient way. And that's all concerning Visual Studio Code. And now we have to verify our installation and everything and check if everything works. So to do so, we will need our File Explorer. We go to this computer, Properties. Additional environment properties, environment variables, and here we look for Java Home variable. Here it is, and triple verify that it leads to Java Development Kit and not the Java runtime environment. So there JDK should go and not the JRE. Yeah. So in my case, it is JDK 1.8.0. That's the first thing. The second thing is the path variable. There are a lot of things there usually. So you should also look for something that relates to Java. In my case, I think I have nothing concerning Java. No. It is here. So you have two path variables, one from the for the user and another for the whole system. So we'll work with the user one. Here it is, Java JDK. It also sh the path should contain the variable which leads to the bin directory inside your JDK installation. So you just ensure that it is here. It should be here if you installed the JDK via the official installer. And also, if you do not have the link to the platform tools here, if you just downloaded them manually and extracted somewhere on your PC, just you should write the path to the platform tools. So in my case, it was in Android SDK Platform Tools. So here it goes, this path. You click OK, and then you restart the computer if something was modified, so that the changes are applied. To verify that you have your platform tools available here, you should type adb jest, and you will see if the adb help is displayed. So adb is Android Debug Bridge and is a module that is used to push the changes that you make in your code from PC to the mobile phone. So that's very useful, yeah, because we shouldn't copy the files manually, and it is required for the toolchain to run. Also, you can use not the Java extension pack and not all this stuff with Visual Studio Code. Another option is just to go to the inner core toolchain, and here in the toolchain folder there are some bat files. These are the scenarios that allow you to run all the tasks you need for the development without Visual Studio Code. However, since we are tending to use the most modern environments and be the most efficient, I would generally recommend to use Visual Studio Code. And in the next short lesson, we will discuss how we can actually do it, how we can import the existing project, how we can create a new one, and how we can run everything with Visual Studio Code. Thank you for your attention.